Hello everybody, Fixxxer here, and today I offer you a new game called Among the Innocent, a Stricken Tale. Now this was developed and published by a small South African indie studio called 0 Degrees Games, and you can get it on Steam for $10. I think the launch sale price is $9. However, the dev was kind enough to provide me with a review copy of this game. So this is an exploration game with point-and-click and puzzle elements, I believe. I normally don't do puzzle games on my channel. They could be kind of a pain to put up on video. At least it is for me. But I found this setting to be pretty interesting, and I wanted to give it a shot. It apparently deals with the five stages. There's going to be five games total, is what I understand. And it deals with the five stages of grief, which is, if I can remember, denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. And I believe this one, I'm assuming this one's denial because that's the first stage, right? I don't know for sure though. I guess we're going to find out. Let's hop right in, I suppose. I just slider until the bar and let this barely... Now this does have... They did describe this as an adventure thriller. Now I don't know exactly what that means. I'm not going to make this super dark because that doesn't lend well to YouTube. So the left is barely visible. Alright, so that means I'm going to go all the way to the right. That way you guys can see it easier. Chapter 1. 0 Degrees Games, etc., etc. This book is so... Okay, let's
just... The autumn night is calm and crisp in the town of Williamsburg, when suddenly its stillness is interrupted by a distant shouting match. Peter York and Stephanie Jacobs are arguing again.
God damn it, just tell me what's on your mind, Peter pleads with his girlfriend. Her response,
it's not that simple, Pete. Just listen, please. We have important things to talk about, but you need to calm down first.
I can't, he cries.
Fine, Steph fumes. She admits defeat once more. Pete's stoicism, an unmovable force when he gets like this.
Fine.
Pete storms out of the house, slamming the door behind him. He needs to cool off. He's trembling. Steph, alone and furious with Pete for another of his childish outbursts, has a lot to think about.
Pete jumps on his motorcycle and tears off into the night.
Of course he does.
Some time passes. Pete cruises along the roads of this quiet part of the world. The country air soothes his nerves. His anxiety begins to simmer to a cool hum now that the confrontation with Steph has slid to the back of his mind. Backed by the calmness washing over him, Pete is filled with a sudden sense of adventure. He turns up a dusty mountain road. The road winds up into the rocky surrounds, its breadth growing narrow as the looming mountains reach taller. Without warning, the ground begins to tremble. Rocks above dislodge from their ancient positions, cascading down and around Pete. He loses control, his bike wobbling like a drunk. It spins out from under him and he is flung to the ground.
That's karma, Pete.
Pete awakens, slowly, groggily. The rocks have fallen in behind him. Together with the high canyon walls, they block his return. His bike lies there, a twisted, useless wreck. Ahead is an open farm gate, and the road continues across a bridge. If he can find a telephone or help, his knee protests as he lurches onwards. He heads off, through the gate, across the bridge. A log cabin is up ahead. There are no lights on, and the area bears a grave stillness. Pete approaches the cabin and knocks on the front door. No answer. He knocks again, more forcefully. Still no response. He creeps open the door. The inside is dark and musty. His footprints leave impressions in the dust as he walks inside.
Hello? Anyone?
Pete is alone. His damaged knee gives in to its injuries and Pete collapses to the floor. His energy is sapped and he needs to rest.
dilapidated couch in the room looks like a luxury compared to sleeping outside, so he decides to lie down, just for a while.
Right. I like the narration. It was well done. It could have been so easy to just let the gamer read the book on his own, her own, either or. And they went a little bit further and got a narrator who did that quite well. I liked it. Lovely. A sudden crashing noise wakes you from a sweaty nightmare. Your clothes are soaked through. Wait, click, or press any key to continue. Ugh, my leg. I need to get out of here. Steph will be worried. Okay. Alright, let's grab my bearings here. See what I can do. I don't move very quickly. I doubt it could take another ounce of weight before collapsing altogether. Okay. Mouse sensitivity a little high. Let's change that real quick. Let's go down here. There, a little bit better. Don't want to give you guys motion sickness. Oh, I can move things. Holy cow. Can I cook? I have no idea. The old kettle is dented all over. Okay. I can't do anything with it. Spice up your life by O. Hunter. Spicy recipes. I do indeed love spicy food. Got better things to do to clean up someone else's mess. Well, you walked in their house. You could at least do their dishes. You picked up an item. Items are stored in your inventory and are automatically used by left-clicking on their corresponding hotspots in the game world. Example, a key can open a lock. Press the I key to access your inventory. I have a lighter. This is your inventory. Collected items are stored here and can be examined and combined if possible. So I right-click to examine, left-click to select an item. Left click on another item. Items you own are automatically used with a left click. My trusty lighter. Okay. Can I not pick up that? Nope. Rustic broom. Anything to eat here? Most of this food expired at least a decade ago. So, this takes place... Sacks of flour. This takes place in Williamsburg, or near Williamsburg. I don't know if it is in or near. South Africa. This place is torn up. Thing. The batteries must be dead. Any batteries? A letter. Crayshore Medical. This is 1982? Interesting. Mrs. Rogers. Following our discussion of your son Charlie, it is my belief that the boy is in need of help, the likes of which I cannot provide. I recommend that you bring him to my good friend and associate Dr. Henry Barnswell, a doctor who specializes in matters of the brain. I strongly urge you to seek help for the boy and indeed your whole family. Please do not hesitate to contact my... rooms? Should you have need of any further? My rooms? Dr. M. Forey. You've collected a note. Whenever this happens, a note is added to your notebook. Press N. I have a notebook. Outpatient prescription. Peter York. T.L. Govender. 2001. All right. Mipropane? I don't know if that's a real drug or not. It doesn't sound like one. Alright, so this is 2001, or at least near 2001, whereas this was dated in 1982. So this is a long-abandoned house, of course. Your first child, Professor D. Bell. Hello. I like that it is automatic. I don't have to go in my inventory and fumble through it. It just works. Well done. That's how I like it. Can't see the finest signals. Might be some interference. Okay. Do they have a radiant barrier? I have a radiant barrier in my house. I don't know if you guys know what that is. It's some kind of material that goes in the attic that is supposed to help with insulation. It keeps the house warm in winter and cool in the summer. Prevents heat from getting in there. Works quite well. However, it is a problem when it comes to getting signals, such as like on my phone. My phone does not work very well in my house, unfortunately. Cell, that is. And I don't have a landline. Can I run? Okay, I can run. Let's go out the back. Did I try that one already? I don't know. Okay. It doesn't seem to be locked, but I can't get the door open. Can I start it on fire? Oops, wrong button. I don't think I can. Can I do that? No. I should put that in the fireplace. I guess I should do that. I don't know what that's going to do. Fireplace is cold. So, how do I set it on fire then? I'm not entirely sure. Can I crouch? No. Oh, there's a cushion. I'm not sure. Is that what I use to, like, start the fire? There we go. That didn't exactly work. I don't know. Alright, I'm gonna leave that go for now. There's another cushion. And another one. So I've got three cushions. I don't know what to do. Looks like someone had a bad day. Oh, there's a lamp. Oh. Is this completely necessary? There is no faucet here. I was going to put water in there, but I guess I can't. Firewood is piled up beneath the sink. Yeah. Whoa, what was that? I saw something different. What was it? I saw something that said something other than shelves, and I don't know what it was. Strange. Alright, well. Oh, God. Dad's to-do list. Chop firewood, fix the washing line, more petrol for the generator, replace valves on gas tank, and help Charlie with the treehouse. Is that my to-do list now? Hello. There was a key there. I am not very observant. Doesn't seem to be locked. This one's locked, though. Gotcha! I need a spider webs and everything. Pardon you. Why am I breathing heavily? What is going on? This? A lamp. Oh, well, shit, I didn't notice that! Human remains, the skeleton remains of what appears to be a woman. It looks like there's something in its hand. Good thing they mentioned that, because I did not notice that. Bag is filled with assortment of marbles? Okay. Oh boy. Can I? Oh, well, I guess I grabbed it. Circuit board model number LM420B, integrated microprocessor, no. Etc., etc. I don't think I need to know anything about this, or do I? There are puzzles in here. I'll need to hook up a power source if I want to use the radio. Speakers connected to the ham. Microphones connected to the ham. Am I actually going to have to put this thing together? I need a power source then? It looks very dark in there. A maze. Uh-oh. Obviously, I drop a marble of some sort in here, and it's a good thing that I actually got a bag. Where do I put the marble, though? I don't know. Do I grab the marble out of my inventory? And marbles of assorted sizes. There's even a goon in there. This that's a very strange looking marble. That might need to be fixed. That's hilarious. Let's take a look at the key real quick. I'm trying to rotate the key. I can't read it. It says locks limited. Something locks limited. All right. Rest the key, it looks like it will fit a padlock, right? Oh, there's doors, and it's locked. Alright, so how do I get the marble in here? I'm looking for a way to hover a hole. Alright, so I gotta do probably this. That probably works. Maybe. Bingo. What do I get for that? I got a coin. I don't know what the coin does, but maybe we'll find out another day. Okay. I don't like that she makes a noise. So, I guess I have to get a power source in order to work on that. So, we'll put that off to later. I don't know where I'm going to get a power source from. Am I supposed to get it from the radio up here? Oh. Can I not unlock that as well? It automatically did the last one. Oh. Oh, look at that. That's what the coin does? Are you for real? Okay. I am so glad I stumbled on that because I am not entirely sure I would have figured that out. Alright, that padlock was useless. Hello there. Power source, anybody? Ooh, I saved the game, I guess. And A. A is for atrophy. Large, sturdy-looking log has fallen into the room. Clearly neglected fish, but complete with an even more neglected fish. Yeah, he looks neglected. Can I reach in there? Is there anything good in there? No. Alright. That kid, apparently his dog died or something. I'll just take that then. I'll leave the crayons. Oh! Hello. What is that? Oh, that's his leash. So the kid's dog died and he went through some grief on his own. What was that? That was the door. And then, of course, the kid had some kind of brain cancer or something, and then the mom went through grief. Alright, I think that's clear. There's activities outside. I want to go outside. So I'm not sure how to light the fire. Or even if I can. Anything else I'm missing? What do I have in my inventory? The key and the lighter. The key doesn't get me out the front door because it's lodged shut or something. And I don't think I can crawl out any of the windows. Guess I'll just walk on top of that. I think I need to keep my eyes better peeled because obviously I wasn't before. Maybe there is something hanging on a wall or something. I want to start the fire. There's got to be a way, right? Can I click off here? No. Debris, a pile of broken logs. Damaged section. Suffered terrible damage. What else am I missing here? I can jump on things. I couldn't jump before. Or no, I wasn't jumping. I was just walking up them, I guess. I don't know. Oh, there, I can jump. I wonder if I can get injured. Aha! What was that? Oh, whoop, whoop. Pillow got jacked up. Interesting that all these pillows are movable. It makes me feel like I can make a pillow fort or something, right? Why are all these pillows here? I have no idea where that one just went. Oh, there it is. Damn, that was close. Works for me. Did I close that? I'm looking for hidden objects. I'm not seeing any. Alright, well, I was hoping there would be something underneath the pillows on the bed, but it does not look like there is. Apparently, I can climb that! Holy cow! Now I'm up on the roof. And I'm breathing heavily. There is a very large treehouse over there. And I'm getting a little bit of a motion blur. I think that's intentional, though. Because my guy's breathing heavily. Hello. Alright, there's a house over there. Jumping from the site would be suicide. I don't know if I would call it suicide. There's a big old tree down. There is a... what was it? Postcard mode. What is that? I see. It gets rid of the crosshair or the dot in the middle of the screen and puts little shade on the corners. Interesting. Okay. Aha! Sweet. Alright, let's check the pooper first. TP, I got another book. Beautiful Gardens in the South African Countryside, Your Guide to Planning, Maintaining, and Nurturing the Perfect Garden by R. Levin. Nothing interesting inside? No. Alright, getting a little bit of an FPS drop, but not too bad. Excuse me. I can't go over rocks, apparently. Alright, that's a little creepy. Whatever. Let's, we need kindling for the fireplace. That might be some kindling in there, eh? Maybe not. How do I get to the front door now? Oh! That's locked. That doesn't matter anyway. Is the front door over here? Ooh, what's this? Can I not get in there? It doesn't feel like I can. Wait a minute. Oh, that's the front door. Yeah, not gonna happen, right? I hope I don't need to go back inside. Can I get back inside through here? I guess so. Or maybe not. We may be out here permanently. Alright, I guess we can explore this. This looks like a road of some sort. A real good lock prevents the barn door from being opened. It won't budge. I got a key, or I got a coin, or I don't have a coin anymore. I don't know why I used up that coin. I don't think using it on four screws should make me lose the coin. What's this? Some kind of irrigation? Okay. How do I get over there? Can I jump this thing? No. It's a plow. Antiquated plow is covered with rust, a testament to its years spent outside in the elements. Can't do anything with that. Alright, I don't think I can do anything in here. What's this? Posting tools. None of this stuff is useful to me. Oh, it's storming outside my house right now. I heard thunder and I thought that was in the game. Alright, we could go around it. I'm at least staying above 50 FPS. I'm getting 60 right now, though. What is that? Is that kind of... is that a zip line of some sort? I had a feeling that wouldn't work. Wait a minute, how does this thing work? Let's follow this pipe here. Well, never mind. It goes that way. Oh, there's a windmill too. And it's barely moving. So I guess this pipe is feeding the water over here, and the valve probably switches it from dumping into here to going over in that hose. Alright, well, I want to get inside this here. Can I not? What is that? I don't think there's anything over here I can do. Alright, well then, where to next? Do I follow the road? Which way do I follow the road? Towards the water, I guess. Let's go that way. It's very bright. Is there a video setting to screen space, ambient occlusion, depth of field? No, I don't think any of this is going to help with that. The ambient inclusion... Oh! No. It looks better with it on, probably, right? Yeah. Yeah, I just wish I could get rid of some of that brightness that, I don't know, what is it? Bloom? It's a little too high for me. I like having music narrating my life there. Let's check out this boathouse. I'm definitely not getting out that way. No, you're not, Peter. There's nothing in here. Can I get in the water, I wonder? No? Jerry can. Cool. So we're looking for fuel somewhere. Why can I move these crates and this shovel? To grab those, maybe? I don't know. Probably not. Are those just lounge chairs? Those are just lounge chairs. I don't think I need them. Alright, I'm gonna leave those crates there. And I guess we're gonna go up here. It probably needs power, I'm guessing, right? Fuel, maybe, with the jerry can? Oh! Oh, I see. What is this over here? Okay. Use jerry can on red thing. Use jerry can on small hose. Small tank. I'm guessing I need fuel first, right? Oh, look at that. Did that work? Oh! That's the right idea, but the jerry can is empty. Okay, okay, I feel ya. Battery brackets. I can access the battery directly. There's no need to remove these brackets. How do I do that? I want to get it off. I can't pry it off. Okay, so... There's no need to... Is that a separate thing, then? Interesting. So, I'm guessing... Large bulbs. I'm guessing that is my power supply, then, right? For the ham? Oops, I clicked off my game. Can't remove the hose with my bare hands. Feels like I need a whole bunch of tools, doesn't it? I can't remove the hose. Can't turn it manually. Oh my god. I need a toolkit. Jesus. The bolts seem tight. Feels oily. You open the air intake box. Okay. Round box. Rectangular box. Holy cow. That seems very complex. Oops, I didn't mean to click on it again. Well, I'm not going on that, at least not until I have fuel for the jerry can. I don't know where I'm going to get that. Maybe I ought to follow the road. There's a random tree on a random island. Following the road might lead me to a car, right? You would think? One would think? What's that? Just flowers. Alright, we're going to take a look at the treehouse, and then I think I'll call it an episode. What is this? Okay. Rope. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. What does that do for me? Alright, so there's this little... I can't tell what that is. Some kind of... bar? And so I need some kind of code, either way, which I definitely don't have yet. Very strange indeed. Alright, so we're not going in the treehouse until I have some kind of code, unless I want to sit there and guess through, well, I guess that could be 999 different combinations, right? Kind of invisible. Oh, there is an invisible. It's an actual fence. And now actual rock. Will I get hurt? Nope, I'm good. Alright, I still haven't found kindling, by the way. And even if I do find kindling, I'm not sure how to get back inside the house. What's this? Just a broken off branch. Alright, well, I think the only other way I haven't gone is down the road here. That looks like sky. Doesn't it? The water? Alright, well, that looks like water there. We got a gate. I'm not sure what exactly that gate is going to stop. There is a bike. Going to guess that we're going to use the jerry can on that, but we'll do that, I think, next episode, because I ran a little bit long on this one, but that's okay. So anyways, that is Among the Innocent, A Stricken Tale. Again, this is one of five games. You can get it on Steam normally for $10. It is on sale right now because it just launched for $9. And thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.